actually driving with my wife, and I got the phone call from Chippendales saying, hey, would you be interested in doing Chippendales? And at first I was kind of like, they do realize I'm 44, right? They said, yeah, we do realize you're 44, but we're trying to take the show in a slightly different direction. And we think you're the guy because we've seen you hosting and we've seen you dance, and we really like both and we love your personality. And I think you're going to be a great host for us. And my wife and I quickly talked about it, and we thought it would be another opportunity for us to be able to further our cause with our charity. So we decided to donate a portion of my salary to my Golf for Special Needs Kids foundation that I have, and it's been a fantastic ride so far. The show, when they said, come in, I said, you know, I have some visions of my own that I want to bring to it. They said, absolutely, but that's exactly what we were looking for. So I decided that I wanted to add a little bit of Latin flavor to it, and I brought my own kind of choreography to it, and the dancers have been so wonderful to work with. In fact, they have stepped up in a big way, and the actual opening number is now mine, and it's quite an impressive number, because I noticed the audience reaction the first time we did it, and I was like, yes, home run, because this is good. And that's what I wanted. I wanted it to feel like everybody's dancing in their seats. In fact, it's such an interactive show. It's almost like watching Dancing with Stars, but you actually get to participate here, which is awesome. My favorite part of the routine and my least favorite part of the routine is the same moment, is when I'm ripping my shirt out. First of all, I'm celebrating that I've done it. And at the same time, I'm hating how much pain I was in for 2.5 months to do it. So I've been working out like crazy, trying to get myself ready for this, doing 2-a-days and dieting and so on. But I couldn't disappoint. You know, to me, it's like, if I'm going to come out here and perform for the fans, I don't want to embarrass the brand. I don't want to embarrass myself and all the things that have always been attached to me, like Dancing with Stars and so on. And more importantly, I always want to represent my family in the best possible way. Number one, when I watched the show the first time, when I watched Chippendales the first time, it was like, am I ever going to be able to stand next to these guys? And from the moment that I met them, I got to tell you, there's a few guys that actually, definitely we became like brothers right off the bat, like Okewa and Ryan and so on. So for me, all these guys have been so welcoming in so many different ways. They've all thanked me for joining them on stage. And the fact that they're making me feel like a part of the family is everything to me. And at the same time, because a lot of the time we get the glory on stage, the backstage, the crew, everybody that operates from makeup to costuming and everything, they are unbelievable here. And they've made me feel really special. And I really do feel like I'm in family now, you know, especially wearing these. The organization started because of the fact that, you know, I happened to drive by a poverty-stricken area in Bridgeport, Connecticut, and I realized that there's a lot of families there, especially single moms, that have fallen on hard times, and they cannot provide the therapies and all the different needs that the special needs kids might need. And I just wanted to make sure that every single kid, as many kids as possible, I can help them have the same things that my son does. You need physical therapy, you need speech therapy, you need occupational therapy, you need all of those things. And in order for those kids to have it, they need transportation, they need to find therapists nearby and so on. So I started as an idea, then Mill River Country Club stepped up in a big way, and we raised $100,000 the first year. And then the second year we raised $250,000. It didn't hit me what I had done until I went to some of those things that my son participates in as well, the group therapies and all that. And I saw those parents watching their kid have a smile on their face and waterworks. I get choked up just talking about it right now, because if there's anything in life you want to do, and that's the most rewarding thing, is charitable work. And when it comes from the right place and it's not for self-interest,
the biggest surprise that I had from Chippendales is how charitable they are.
They go around town. Vegas is a better place because of Chippendales. They have supported the AIDS Walk. They've supported so many different charities. And now, today, they surprised me with an incredible check from my foundation, which, you know, the organization has been so fantastic to me already. And the fact that they care about my cause and they're trying to further my mission in life, it's talk about marriage made in heaven, because this brand is unbelievable in every which way. You know, Chippendales as a brand has always had a great name in doing charitable work, but for me, they have just
become... Vegas is also home for us, because we have a dance studio, Dance With Me Dance Studios in Tivoli Village.
So for me, Vegas has always been a big part of my life. In fact, I hosted Dancing with the Stars when it was at Tropicana, and I've done a lot of charitable work around here. I've done a lot of the, like, Derek Jeter's golf tournament that he has here in Vegas. So there's been a lot of things that I've done with Vegas in a great way, because I feel like Vegas is one of the most giving places you could ever meet. I mean, meaning people are so giving in so many different ways that you don't realize
how sweet people are here in Vegas. Because if you only come here and you just stay on the Strip, you have missed out on the greatest part of Vegas.
I am a people person. I love people, and I like hanging out with them. I'm not one of those people that's like, oh, don't take a photo. Come and hang out with me. Come talk to me. The best thing is don't even try to sneak peek. Come and ask me, or come just tell me. That's all that matters. I decided to do a cruise, actually, and get to really hang out with the fans and go swimming, go partying, teach them a dance, go excursions, go on scooters, whatever it is, as we go around in the Tony Dovolani, you know, cruise with Tony Dovolani, which is actually kind of fun. If you go to my Instagram page, you could actually go there. In fact, they're offering some cool deals in there, which is awesome. But I can't wait to meet the fans on a cruise because I love vacationing and I love cruises. And we're going to some pretty cool places. There's going to be a lot of margaritas.
Love everything you do with your foundation as well. So, Chippendales would like to make a donation as a welcome to the family gift. We're going to make a $5,000 donation to the Tony Dovolani Foundation.
I am like, whoa. I got to do
this. And then eyes to the left one more time. All right, hold on.
To the center.
One more straight ahead.
You can see he's doing the ritual mating dance.
Hold on.
Mess with the boo, go get the taco.
I'm a minotaur.
Guest host from Dancing with the Stars, Tony Dovolani.
record because when I say your name, you get up and show me your best move. Amy. Sorry, who? All right, well, we'll see if she's got...